we had requested a committee consisting of Mr. Kambari, Mr. Ralsan, and Mr. have done in the last 1 year. But one or two points I wanted to mention about. Number one, there is a paragraph here, there is a subhead here, that is integrity pact. I find a lot of details have been given there. I'll be very happy if we could be also informed what has been the impact of all these activities in actually doing something worthwhile. Okay. Because simply listing all these things is one part. What is the impact? That is number one. Number two, Mr. Chairman, I learn about Transparency International primarily when I come to attend the general body meeting. It's a very important organization. When I talk to my friends around the country and talk to them about it, there is hardly anyone who knows about Transparency International. In a situation today, when corruption is a topic of the day, when everyone is scared of going to an administrative office and getting something done because corruption is there, it is in that context, sir, my humble request is that you create a mechanism within Transparency International so as to tell the public what actually you are doing.
Newsletters.
Actually, nobody knows about it. We sometime hear that there is a report, India has been listed at 120 or whatever as a corrupt country and so on, and that's the end of the whole thing. Is it possible that the Transparency International office here creates a sort of a liaison office which coordinates with the media, coordinates with the public, so that people come to know and more people join hands with you? It is in that context I thought I'll make a submission to you that creates some mechanism so people can know what are the objectives of Transparency International and what can they do for the benefit of the society. Thank you.
I want to cover pros and pros. I think this is being a little emotional. We cannot cover pros and pros. And whatever we are doing, in fact, tomorrow I am going to give a lecture to the school in Muzaffarnagar. I am invited. And every effort we should concentrate in our local area instead of being very emotional that we should cover whole country. We know we cannot cover whole country, whatever we talk about it. And more important is administering pledge is only a ceremonial thing. It doesn't mean that if 1,000 boys and girls, they take pledge and tomorrow they will become honest. So let us insist on the ceremony of administering pledge. Yes, but we should tell them what is the benefit of being honest, what is the disadvantage and loss and harm of the dishonesty, all that we should tell. But we should not be emotional, we should be realistic. Thank you.
I think I have to shed modesty to say this. 1979, you are all entered to me, when...
Not me.
No.
I
withdraw
the right. Most of us. Making this background in this background that I do not know even 1% of what Justice Kamleshwar Nath knows. That is a confession which normally criminal lawyers do not make. I am making this confession. My knowledge of law and wisdom is not even 1% of my Lord Justice Kamleshwar Nath. That I am very clear. I am mindful of. But then, why did I give my opinion on the judgment? Because this opinion was sought by the chairman. And why my opinion becomes not what it has been, for that I was giving this background. 1979, I was not even enrolled as a lawyer. I was only a law graduate. So all the legal luminaries, D.M. Tarkunde, Shanti Bhushan, Pali Nariman, Ram Jethmalani, everybody opined that this advice of Charan Singh, the then Prime Minister, should not be accepted. And the house should not be dissolved. I write a letter on that. The moment I read this, I said, I am also a student of constitution. They are all legal luminaries. Then why is it happening? Why are they giving wrong opinion? So I sent a letter. शांति भूषण नारीमन ये सारे जितने और लीगल ल्यूमिनरीज जिन्होंने अपना ओपिनियन दिया है इनकी नॉलेज तो बहुत बढ़िया है लेकिन इनकी नियत ठीक नहीं है. एंड यू ऑल नो दैट ओपिनियन वाज एक्सेप्टेड, दैट इज पार्लियामेंट वाज डिसॉल्वड. सिमिलर थिंग हैज हैपेंड हियर. ऑल्दो माय नॉलेज ऑफ लॉ इज वेरी पुअर, बट आई वेंट प्योरली ऑन एथिक्स. आई रोट टू टीआई दैट वी एज कॉन्शियस कीपर ऑफ द सोसाइटी शुड नॉट गो इनटू टेक्निकलिटीज. इफ द कोर्ट डिसमिस द केस, इट इज अ मटेरियल मैटर. Because, sir, gentlemen, I would like to bring to your notice, court categorically said, but Mr. Sharan is here.
Yes, I am here.
और sir, आप हैं वो, मैं आपको salute करता हूँ sir.
नहीं नहीं, लेकिन मुझे
हाँ वो आपकी बारी आएगी ना, आपको आपको तो salute कर रहा हूँ. इनकी केस में court ने categorically कहा कि there was no justification for active member as you raised. He said there is no criteria. How could you have this active membership? And that to an organization which is fighting against corruption of all the people.
Sir,
you claim to be. One second, let me complete, gentlemen. You get your chance.
Yes.
Yes.
Do not have to
shout every time, Mr. Arora. One second. I'm making a submission. What is shouting?
Sir, I love you. This is not
a court
of law.
What? I'm making a point.
It is.
I know it is not court. Mr. Rajan, can you allow me to speak?
My submission is.
This point of order would come from chairman, not from anybody else.
My submission is.
I'm speaking. If my voice is rudial, I can't help.
No.
Mr. Rajdhan, should I tell you one thing? Everything when it is stressed upon, it looks that you are shouting.
I think his voice is forceful.
My, it is not forceful. Ma'am, it happens. If I say, Baba Sahib, I love you. So I say that. If I say, Baba Sahib, you are wrong. Mr. Rajdhan, I have been a teacher of communication skills for 3 decades. So I don't need tips, but I must tell you. If I tell you, if Baba Sahib, I love you, Baba Sahib. I'll say that thing. But if I say Baba Sahib, you're wrong, sir.
So then I'm not saying Baba Sahib, you're wrong, sir.
Then we acknowledge all your
students. So sir, what I am saying, same thing has happened here. In that judgment, the judge categorically says there was no justification for this. This criteria of active membership is totally unjustified. There are no guidelines. This is, I'm sorry to say, I feel ashamed as a member of TI that a civil judge passed strictures against TI. He also said that it is a limitation. The issue was limitation. He said limitation is a I told them limitation is only technical thing. And then there is a procedure. If you want to make any rules or amendment, there is a procedure prescribed under Society Registration Act that you give letter to every member, circulate it, give them 30 days notice, and then let everybody come with the suggestions. Put it before the General House. When the General House accepts that, then you send it to the Register of Society. The Register of Society would accept that, and then that becomes a rule. I said, we are flouting all these rules as TI India. I mean, should we not be ashamed of us? That is why I said that Justice Kamleshwar Nath's opinion is totally, not only unscrupulous, unethical also. Because his knowledge of law is clear. But he as board member, now again, the point came, how can you be judge of your own cause? He as board member is deciding that this is legal.
All right.
He says, I have no financial interest. One second, let me complete. He says, I have no financial interest. Financial interest is only
part
of it. It was interest of conscience. If you are not having even conscience, then I can't help. Then
okay.
Only God can save me. So my view is that this is unjustified since the court has said it is unjustified. It is unscrupulous. It becomes unscrupulous if the court says that. And we should not follow this unless the whole house approves that.
All right.
Yes.
All right.